ahead.
The people in our lives will be with us forever. When we can see them, they make our lives seem better. Happiness and joy, memories galore, then the physical appearance becomes no more. The good times we remember, the bad we try to forget, finding fault in ourselves and filled with regret. Regretting the way we've lived our lives, regretting the things left undone. And into our minds comes a number, the one and only, number one. One more minute, a minute to say goodbye. One more hour, an hour to fly through the memories of a wonderful life. Looking back at how life changes and how life by time rearranges. One more day, a day to find a deeper meaning to the life of someone you love, finding in you a different meaning. One more week, a week to make another memory to relieve our minds of what eventually has to be. One more month, a month to catch up on what we miss, pictures, stories, memories, friends, temporarily in a discontinuous bliss. One more year, the year we need to learn to relive a life we never should have left behind. Yet God will guide us to just believe, because he now has the number one. One more angel to spread her wings, flying around as our heart desires. One more angel to help with things. One more angel to watch over those she left behind. One more angel to be ever loving and kind. One more angel with which to share his kingdom, glory, and ever loving care. As she watches from above, we will wait here below, waiting for the day that no one can know. The day that will come when we can be together in heaven as one big happy family.
Ginger and cursed and sometimes soulless. You think of stereotypes. You think of one biological thing, one little thing that everyone notices or sometimes doesn't notice but still uses. You can look at race, sexuality, religion, gender, any of these things. They equivalent one small thing that makes up one human. When you say human, it's not one. It's many. You can look at a girl who practices an Islamic faith. What you don't know about her is that she loves her brother. She loves to paint. She dreams of being a veterinarian. She dreams of being married someday and pleasing Allah with her life. When you look at a young boy with cerebral palsy, what you don't know is he wants to be a Lego master builder. He wants to show his sister how much he loves her, and he wants to be there on her first prom because he knows he can't go to his. When you look at anyone, you look at one factor first to judge. Why are you judging by that one factor? What one factor can you judge yourself on? Are you just going to take that one word, nice, polite, quiet, loud, talkative? I put your whole life behind that? No. You have a list for yourself. Make that list for others. Expand it constantly. Because every time you see someone, it's a human being. That's a million qualities and more that'll take three lifetimes to get to know all of them. That human being may not even know this, but those qualities, but they can know those one things from that person, that they are loved, that they will be loved, and that they are forever beautiful.
Okay, I got another one. Yes, me, always in the spot. Always what I do.
Okay, some of you may have heard this one because I did it for Mosaic last year. Here is the truth that I can't stand, the truth that threatens to break through my mind and body and soul. I want you to know my secret. If you came to me, told me you loved me, I would be a bird, flying to the rooftops with nothing but happiness beneath my wings. Because truth be told, I love you. Truth be told, I need you. Truth be told, some nights I sit wanting nothing more than to be alone, while other nights I just want to be at home in your arms, even though I know that you don't love me. Truth be told, some nights I sit wondering how the hell I'm gonna make it to the next sunrise. And no, I've never seen the sunrise, but I've seen the specks of color in your eyes, which is a million times better than that stupid sun ever thought it could be. And yes, I've done some things that are borderline crazy, things that are certifiably crazy, and no, you don't necessarily know, because I can't stand to make your life more difficult by burdening you with my problems. Tomorrow marks 1 year. 1 year since we sat on that bus side by side, as you taught me that there was more than black and white. You taught me about gray and every color in between. And if you say you didn't teach me these secrets, I would say, okay. But you brought them up to my face, and I got closer than I ever thought possible. Truth be told, I miss them. My secret drips through every word on this page. I love you, I still love you, even though it has taken me 9 months to even begin to get over those 3 months. I will always love you. Truth be told, I've kept some secrets from you. Secrets I'm too afraid to say. That's why I'm sitting here pouring my heart onto this page, trying to rework and redefine what I'm saying. I wish I had the confidence to write ink, but I need the flexibility to erase and start all over. Truth be told, I'm still very, very young, stupid, and naive. You're still young, but in my eyes, seemingly wise beyond your years. Truth be told, I just miss the way things used to be.
I sit here thinking, contemplating, analyzing now and then, lusting for a difference. Once more, it is all so familiar. The look, the thought, the feeling. One more night I sit here. I wait for tomorrow. I cry for broken dreams. I fail to sleep for haunting things. One more night goes by minute, tick for tick, thought for thought. One more night, it seems, brings hope, brings sadness, brings feelings of the unknown. One more night, I think, I cry, I scream, I dream. Tomorrow is one more day for hope, for love, for dreams. One more night is not worth my dreams, my friends, or my tomorrows. One more night I go on, dreaming, thinking, feeling. One more night brings hope of the sunrise, a new day and a new chance. One more night brings new courage.
Facebook, so Facebook saved the day today. This one's called In Your Arms. Oh, take away my fear, calm the fires raging in my heart.
Oh, there's a backside.
Take away the pangs of guilt that stain the white robe of my heart. Take away my pain, wash me of my brother's sin. Take away my bitterness, oh, rinse me of my false guilt. Renew in me the innocence you gave me from the start. Renew in me the light that brought me from the dark. Oh, release me of my bonds. Quell the unrest rampant in my soul. Release me from the prison of doubt in the depths of my soul. Rescue your lamb from sacrifice. Restore purity to its proper place. Warm the frozen frown upon its face. Oh, hold me in your healing arms. In your arms. Thank you.
Man. Often the struggler has given up when he might have captured the victor's cup. And he learned too late when the knight slipped down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems afar. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worse that you mustn't quit.
So